Hello everyone, I'll be talking about lung neoplasms today. Lung tumors are broadly classified as benign and malignant tumors. Most of the benign tumors are asymptomatic and they usually present as solitary pulmonary nodules. Of the benign tumors, the hamartomas are the commonest. The other benign tumors include squamous cell papilloma, benign connective tissue tumors and bronchial adenoma. Coming to the lung cancer is the most common cause of death from cancer worldwide. It amounts to around 1.1 million deaths per year, and it's more common in males compared to the females. It's mostly seen in the age group 50 to 75 years. Based on the histopathological appearance of the tumor cells, lung cancer is broadly divided into small cell lung cancer and non-small cell lung cancer. The small cell lung cancer constitutes about 15 to 20% of all lung cancers, whereas the non-small cell lung cancer constitutes 80% of all the lung cancers. The non-small cell lung cancer includes squamous cell carcinoma, adenocarcinoma and large cell carcinoma. The adenocarcinoma is the commonest. Coming to the etiology of lung cancer, the cigarette smoking is the single most important factor responsible for 90% of the lung cancer cases. And the risk increases with the amount of cigarette smoke per day. The cigarette contains various carcinogenic substances like acetone, naphthalene, methanol, carbon monoxide, vinyl chloride, arsenic, etc. Other risk factors include atmospheric pollution in urban areas, radiation exposure, household coal combustion. There is also familial predisposition to lung tumors, occupational exposure to asbestos, arsenic, chromium, uranium, nickel, vinyl chloride, all can cause lung carcinoma. Pre-existing lung diseases such as COPD, idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis and tuberculosis can also predispose to lung carcinoma. Few studies showed that mutation in epidermal growth factor receptor can also lead to lung carcinoma. Coming to the clinical features, the common symptoms of lung cancer include persistent cough. In the initial days, the cough is usually dry. If there is a secondary infection, it can be productive. If there is secondary infection, the cough can be productive. And patient can also present with shortness of breath, hemoptysis, there will be unexplained weight loss, anorexia, and there will be repeated respiratory infections. And tumor, usually the centrally placed tumors, they can cause bronchial obstruction. There is bronchial obstruction, patient can present with the wheeze and stridor. Stridor is commonly seen if the tumor is placed, the primary tumor is in the larynx, trachea or the central bronchus. The spread to the mediastinal structures like esophagus can cause dysphagia. And the invasion of the pericardium can lead to erythema, pericardial effusion. The left-sided tumors, when they involve the left recurrent laryngeal nerve, they can cause vocal cord paralysis and patient presents with bovine cough. And the invasion of the phrenic nerve lead to diaphragmatic paralysis. The tumor can also compress upon the superior vena cava and it leads to superior vena cava syndrome, where the patient presents with the distension of the wings on the chest and the neck. There will be suffusion and swelling of the face and eyes. The patient also presents with headache. And extrathoracic metastasis can happen to the brain, bones, liver and lymph nodes. Metastasis into the brain can present as focal neurological deficits, epilepsy, headache, etc. And the bone, invasion to the bone can present as bone pain. Invasion to the liver, a patient can present as abdominal pain and jaundice. Most of the times the lung neoplasms can also present as paraneoplastic syndrome. These can be the initial features. These paraneoplastic syndromes are due to the hormonal factors secreted by the tumor cells or by an immune response against the tumor. It is commonly seen with the small cell carcinoma. The paraneoplastic syndromes, they commonly present as fever, weight loss, cachexia. The endocrine manifestations can be SAADH, ectopic ACTH secretion, and hypercalcemia, mainly because of the ectopic parathyroid hormone related peptide secretion. This, there can be skeletal manifestations like hypertrophic pulmonary osteoarthropathy. You can see here in the X-ray, there will be periosteitis of the distal radius and ulna, and patient also will have local tenderness in that area and pitting edema. And neuromyopathic manifestations like Lambert-Eaton syndrome, where there will be antibodies against the voltage-gated channels in the presynaptic area. Patient can have peripheral neuropathy, dermatomyositis. This is a picture of dermatomyositis. There can also be hematological manifestations like Trousius syndrome, where patients will have migratory venous thrombophlebitis. Patient can have disseminated intravascular coagulation, anemia, eosinophilia, etc. The renal manifestations can be nephrotic syndrome and glomerulonephritis. Coming to the investigations, the chest X-ray is very important. Chest X-ray, PA view, usually PA view is taken. It can show mass lesion, collapse of the whole lung lobe or segments. There can be pleural effusion. There can be elevation of hemidiaphragm. Mediastinal widening can be there. And invasion into the chest wall structures, there can be rib destruction. This is a chest X-ray showing the mediastinal shift on the right side. You can see the trachea shifted to the right here. And there is also elevation of diaphragm, which is not quite apparent in this. And on the left, you can see the lung is emphysematous. This is another X-ray showing a tumor in the left lung. This is the first image shows the PA view, and the second one shows the lateral view. CT chest and abdomen is very important for staging of the tumor, and CT also helps in taking biopsy from the suspected lesions. Other investigations include cytological examination of the sputum, bronchial brushings and washings. FNAC of the involved lymph nodes can also be taken. PET scan along with the CT scan helps in better staging of the disease. It also helps in the management of the lung carcinoma. Bronchoscopy helps in the direct visualization of the tumor, central tumors mostly, and they also help in taking a biopsy. Pleural aspiration and biopsy is required in case the patient develops pleural effusion. Mediastinoscopy and molecular testing for epidermal growth factor receptor mutations are the other investigations. Coming to the staging, non-small cell carcinoma is staged into stages 1 to 4, mainly based on the size, location of the primary tumor, involvement of the lymph nodes and distant metastasis. Please do read about the TNM staging. The small cell carcinoma is broadly divided into limited and extensive stage based on whether the tumor can be encompassed with a tolerable radiation therapy port. Coming to the treatment, surgical resection carries the best hope of long-term survival. Radical radiotherapy is usually combined with chemotherapy when lymph nodes are involved. Highly targeted radiotherapy may be given in 3 to 5 treatments for small lesions. For complications such as superior vena cava obstruction, recurrent hemoptysis and pain caused by chest wall invasion or skeletal metastatic deposits, radiotherapy can be used palliatively. This laser therapy and stenting, they are used to temporarily relieve the obstruction. Coming to the prognosis, the prognosis of lung carcinoma is very poor. 70% of the patients usually die within a year of diagnosis, and only 6 to 8% survive 5 years after the diagnosis. The best prognosis is usually seen with well-differentiated squamous cell tumors that have not metastasized. Coming to the secondary tumors of the lung, the secondaries usually come to the lung through the blood-borne route, and they particularly come from the breast, kidney, uterus, ovary, testis and thyroid. These secondary deposits are usually multiple and bilateral. These secondary metastasis from other organs can also involve the lymph nodes, and this can lead to lymphangitic carcinomatosis, which leads to rapidly progressive breathlessness with marked hypoxemia. This is chest X-ray showing multiple secondaries. Please do quit smoking. It's very harmful. Thank you.